Star Wars The Rise of Skywalker is now just 27 days away from its official release by Disney, Lucasfilm, J.J. Abrams, and even director, of course, and creator George Lucas. That is all set and ready to end the sequel trilogy and the Skywalker saga itself. This is Mike Zero. Make sure to subscribe if you're new to the channel for future Star Wars content. Now, one major aspect of Episode 9 that a lot of fans are very much curious about is, of course, exactly what's going to happen between both Rey and Kylo Ren in Episode 9, and exactly how it's all really going to unfold between Adam Driver and Daisy Ridley's portrayal of these characters from start to finish of this movie. Now, as you all know, a lot of changes and adjustments have been made throughout the months of 2019, especially August, September, and October, which is when they had a lot of different transitions of this movie, and the core of the plot of Episode 9 being shifted around by Disney, Lucasfilm, Kathleen Kennedy, you name it. Now, on top of all of this, what's rather unfortunate to some fans has all to do with the concept of Reylo in Episode 9 involving Rey and Kylo Ren's relationship in The Rise of Skywalker. Now, specifically, what's really intriguing about this is that it's described that during the reshoots, many changes and adjustments were made to the second and third acts of the film, where it's explained that one of the major changes had to do with how the core characters would be handled in the film by Disney and Lucasfilm, and that many aspects of the film would be switched around by Kathleen Kennedy. Now, it's explained that one of the major scenes that were deleted in the process involved a vital scene in the third act of the film that was considered a Reylo-heavy scene in which both Ben and Rey exchange a kiss scene inside of Palpatine's throne room just before Ben Solo decides to fight Sidious by himself to protect and defend a lethargic Rey after getting drained from Palpatine's new technique called Force Conduit. The kiss scene between Adam Driver and Daisy Ridley was said to have been cut by Kathleen Kennedy over at Lucasfilm, and that Disney and Lucasfilm didn't want to have a romantic moment in the battle or in the third act of the film and decided to keep the Rey and Kylo relationship scenes low-key and not shown in direct or obvious ways for fans. Kathleen Kennedy was said to be the one who proposed this idea to director J.J. Abrams, and that it had a major impact on the structure of the scene after getting cut in the kiss scene between both Rey and Kylo Ren out of the film. So let's go over a couple of parts about this and as to why this is a very unfortunate thing by Disney and Lucasfilm for some fans out there. Now, there are a lot of fans who support Reylo. There are also a lot of fans who despise the concept of Reylo. And then you have people like me who's kind of in between where I could see where it would work and I could also see how it would be a little difficult to go through those obstacles since we know Kylo Ren is a person who murdered his own father, a person who destroyed millions of lives, hence Hosnian Prime, and all those different aspects. I mean, that's just the start of it. Luke Skywalker's new generation of Jedi, you name it. You know, between Anakin and Padme, it was a different story because he wasn't Darth Vader just yet. And the same exact thing goes for Han and Leia, is because obviously Han was a good man at the end of the day. So when we look at the character of Kylo Ren, I guess that's where the obstacles came into play here, is because they weren't quite sure exactly what was the best scenario for both Rey and Kylo Ren. Now, do I think that this is a good decision? I'm not quite sure what I could really say to that other than the fact that I would have honestly preferred just a little thing of romance in a Star Wars sequel trilogy movie because it seems like it's a tradition. I mean, let's just say that. It is a tradition within Star Wars. There's no doubt about that. If you look at the prequels, we have a little romance there. If you look at the originals, there's also a little romance there. You know, it's a part of Star Wars, and it's the one thing of the sequel trilogy that seems to be non-existent, and that's why I think it feels a little off at times. You know, you have nothing between Rey and Poe, nothing between Rey and, you know, Finn. That was pretty much disregarded. And now the whole Finn and Rose thing is off. I don't know if you guys knew this, but in the new Resistance Reborn book, it's a very interesting passage out of the book where it actually does explain that Finn tells Poe that he and Rose are just friends. And the same exact thing goes for Rey, just friends. And that leaves us with Rey and Kylo Ren. So they actually wanted to leave the Rey and Kylo Ren relationship low-key. That's what Kathleen Kennedy wanted to do with The Rise of Skywalker, was to keep it low-key and to not make it too obvious or too direct for the general audience. And I think that a kiss scene would have been fine. I know that they actually filmed a number of scenes, number of different takes of Kylo Ren kissing Rey on the cheek. No mention of anything on the lips or anything around those lines. Something that you would never see in a Disney Star Wars movie, from what it seems, at least. So with that being said, you know, I can understand how fans are very much, you know, just underwhelmed about that, or just very let down about the fact that they would not even have anything like that involved in The Rise of Skywalker. But at the same exact time, you know, I could also understand why they would get rid of this, because it's a very tough decision. It really is, because you have Kylo Ren, who is a very, you know, evil person who has killed, you know, tons of people, even his own father, Luke's Jedi students, you name it. And to actually go from that to Reylo, it's a hard decision to make, so I'm not quite sure exactly what to say, but I will say that they could have at least done a little bit of a romance, make it quick, nothing too big, and then just move on. The fact that they're not even going to have any kind of exchange like that, I think, is a missed opportunity, because it's a tradition of Star Wars. Nothing too big, it's just a tradition of Star Wars. So anyways, guys, drop a comment below. Let me know what you think about all of this in the comments. And if you guys did enjoy the content for today, do make sure to drop a thumbs up on this video to support the channel. I thank you all so very much for the kind support, and I'll catch you guys next time.